Hi friends, it's such an amazing feeling to talk to students from one single institute, from the one medical college, from one center who have scored amazing results. So continuing with this, right now I am sitting with Dr. Akarshi Gupta. Dr. Akarshi Gupta is a student from KGMU. She was a scholar throughout. She has got 25 medals from the MBBS. And not just this, now the biggest thing for an MBBS graduate, she has scored rank 23 in the NEET PG 2020. A very, very big congratulations,
thank
Akarshi.
You,
so, Akarshi, how does it feel when your hard work finally pays off and you are relieved for the next 3 months?
So it feels amazing. The first day when I saw the result, sir, it was a very relaxing feeling that now I don't have to study that hard for AIIMS. So just it feels great now.
So Akarshi, for the students at KGMU who are interns,
yes,
the
sir.
First exam that you people write is basically the NEET.
Yes, sir.
Because your internship is not finishing by 31st January.
Yes, sir.
So you are not eligible for the AIIMS.
Yes,
so this is the first exam, and the first exam always has got a lot of stress.
Yes,
so how you were able to control that, and specifically when you're the topper of the college also,
yes,
there are always some expectation. We had expectations from you. You also had expectations from you. So that expectation gives you further more stress. So how you were able to handle that stress?
So giving regular GTs and GCLTs gave me confidence that I can do it. And I myself tried to relax myself that it's okay if I don't get a rank, then just relax.
Are you sure you were like that if okay if it will not be there?
So yes sir, I'm quite
okay.
Relaxed, yes,
you're relaxed on that.
Yes, sir.
So I feel that reduces your stress, and
yes,
in the stress you are not able to perform to the best of your efforts.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so Akarshi, you joined us in the second year MBBS,
yes,
as a pre-foundation student, and you were with us for the 4 year.
Yes,
so how was your journey with us in the DBMCI? That is just one part. The second part is I want you to tell the entire your journey about the preparation, how you utilize your DBMCI, because as when we're discussing, I came to know that you were exclusively associated with us. I mean, you were not a part of any other institute. You have not attended any, like there are a lot of single classes, video classes and all. You are not a part of any other class. So you solely relied on one particular source. So I'm sure that movement of FOMO, fear of missing out, is also coming. So how you were able to control on all this? Because I feel that those students who are able to control all this, they are the one who are able to reach up to this particular level. So how you were able to control on all to all this, how you utilize the DBMCI for the 4 years, and you did your own studies and able to reach to this rank?
So after joining, I joined DBMCI in second year. I did first year and second year subjects in second year. Then during the
you were regular with the classes in the
yes,
second year?
Yes,
a lot of people, they join, but they are not very focused. Ki chalo kar lete hain.
No, sir. I was regular.
You
yes,
were
sir.
Regular. Okay.
In second year, I did first and second year. Then during third year, I did rest of the 12 subjects. Then during internship, I repeated all the classes.
Okay. So again, like if I just put forward, your standard is that by the third year,
yes, sir,
your 19 subjects were complete.
Yes, sir.
So you had the notes of the 19
yes,
subjects
sir.
With you.
Yes, sir.
That in the final year MBBS, basically, you did not attend the classes, but
yes,
then you read your standard books.
Yes, sir.
And then in the internship, again, you attended all the 19 subjects once
yes,
again.
Sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
All right.
So attending classes during internship, after attending classes during third year, becomes a revision. Like you are revising in the class, then it's very helpful because there are concepts which you can just grasp in one go. Then the classes are very helpful for that. You have to revise it 2-3 times, then you will be able to grasp that. Sometimes the teacher says and it stays in your mind, and then that question comes directly in the exam, then you are like extremely happy.
Can you give some examples of that, what happened?
Yes, sir. So once Thameem sir asked in the class, was the drug of choice or invasive aspergillosis, and that question came directly in the exam. So, like, these
so
things
do you
happen.
Know, this is specifically true with Dr. Thameem's class. I still remember I was a student of Dr. Thameem's, and once you write the paper, it comes to your mind that, okay, sir has said
yes,
this,
sir.
It is written on the right side of the column. In my notes on that particular, and I don't know why that man has that particular
yes,
charisma.
Sir.
In fact, once I'll tell you that But the moment you attend his class, you feel your notes are so less. I don't know how you will be able to complete the medicine.
Yes, sir.
But once you attend the paper, then you realize ki bhai itna hi chahiye tha.
Yes, sir.
That was the only thing that was required.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So please continue.
So regarding books and DBMCI, sir, I mainly focused on during internship. I mainly focused on notes, and I used review books only for MCQs or some topics which I thought were important to be read from the book. And mainly it was notes during internship. Yes, sir.
And we completed the course in September.
Yes, sir.
Okay, then how did you utilize Vibe?
So Vibe just served as a revision. Like, we have completed all the subjects, we have given GCLT first one. So it was just like a revision. We are revising all the images and the important topics. They were in Vibe, there were images of all the important topics. So in the last 10 days, I used to revise the images and
from the booklet.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
The Vibe booklet, I found it very helpful.
Okay. All right. Did you write GCLT?
Yes, sir.
What was your score or the rank?
So in first GCLT, my rank was 41 and okay. In second, it was 8.
It was 8. So again, the same reproduction that has come from the result. I think that getting the rank at the Pan India level among so many students also gives you a lot of confidence that yes, you are going on a right track and you are going on a right path. Akarshi, how important it is for the students to do the MCQs?
So it's very important. So sometimes we read theory and we are not able to apply it for a question. I think doing questions is very important to just get the feel that how you will be able to solve it, like catching those small points from the question, like what will give you hint for towards the diagnosis or towards the question, next best step. So it's very important to practice questions.
Okay. How, I'm sure that once you were writing the paper, you were very regular with the classes,
yes, sir.
Your result, not just for this, even the entire MBBS
yes,
speaks
sir.
For your caliber. But I am sure once you are doing the MCQs, there are always some mistakes that you come across.
Yes, sir.
That, oh, I could have done this right
yes,
and I did it wrong.
Yes, sir.
How you were able to improve on those mistakes?
Sir, I mainly used to mark wrong those questions in which there is something like not, this should not be there, or something that were negative questions. Double negative
so you're missing
questions.
Except double
yes,
negative.
Sir, yes,
okay.
sir. Double negative questions were the one that I was making silly mistakes on. So I, when I used to give GTs, I used to focus that I have to read the question very carefully so that I generally don't read the question twice that seriously. Like you have to read it in one go very carefully. So just that I paid more attention to.
Okay, When we talk about the images,
yes,
like
sir.
Were you scared about the images?
No, sir.
Okay. What about this year NEET paper?
So it was more clinical. I would suggest the students to start attending clinical classes. Like the postings were very helpful. I think they should start attending it from the second year itself. In our college, we start attending postings, evening postings from second year. When we elicit sign ourselves, then we are able to better memorize it. It just goes into your mind. Like you don't have to read it again and again. It just goes in.
Okay. Akarshi, there is a very challenging question that I want to ask you here is, you are exclusively associated with us.
Yes, sir.
And like nowadays, everybody is active on social media.
Yes.
There are a lot of your friends also. Now, there will be you gonna come across a lot of people that they will say, I have joined this also, I have joined this also, I have joined this also.
Yes,
you keep on looking at the information that is coming from different places
yes,
also.
Sir.
And I'm sure there are a lot of things that are coming to you also that you are not aware of.
Yes, sir.
And then you are that scared. So I keep on talking about fear of missing out.
Yes, sir.
How you are able to handle that, that you are at one place?
Yes, sir.
Okay, and not associated with any other place, still and getting the dream that I want to get this particular rank. So how you were able to control on all this?
So mainly, I thought that if I would not be able to retain that much, what's the point of reading that? So I think that gave me the strength to stick to the one point only.
Okay, and see the result is here.
Yes, sir.
So this is an important message that I want to give to everybody, that please try to read the things in a way so that you can recall in the exam. Okay, so I keep on saying in the classes also, there is no point reading to the things that you are not able to recall in the exam. Exam is not just about your knowledge, it is more about how much you are able to recall in the exam. And see, all the things that we are coming up, all the interviews that we are taking, they have one thing in common, that they have tried to retain the things. Okay, and then it doesn't matter whether you know two more topics or whether you know two less topics. If you are able to recall onto the thing, because we know the paper in and out, we know what are the things that they're gonna point, they're gonna pay attention to. If you're gonna just focus onto all these things, this game is all yours, all yours. Any special message that you want to give to the students who are watching this interview, who have a personality like you, who want to achieve such a great result?
So I would just like to say, read less, but read it again and again, so that you are able to recall it during the exam. Read in a way that it goes into your mind. Don't just mug up things. Like, it should be part of you. Like, you should be able to recall it during the exam. While solving the question, it should come naturally. Like, the diagnosis should come naturally. It should not be that you are focusing too much on a particular thing that you have retained or not. It should become natural.
Once again, a big congratulations, Akarshi. So, Akarshi, rank 23 NEET PG 2020, a student of KGMU, our exclusive student with DBMCI Lucknow Center. Very proud of you.
Thank you.